Good morning, students. I am Kuldeep Singh. I am teaching you physics in class 10. In the class, we had discussed about the chapter 1, physics, that is force. And in that topic, I told you that according to the principle of moments in equilibrium, sum of anti-clockwise moment is equal to sum of clockwise moment. And related to this, some numericals are very important, which can be expected in the ICSE as well as the terminal exam. So on page number 8, the numerical number 8, 9 and 10, these three numericals are very important. We can expect that one of the numerical we will get in the terminal exam or final exam. So today, students, I am going to explain you about the topic center of gravity. First of all, what is gravity or what is gravitational force? The gravitational force of attraction between two masses is always attractive in nature, and Earth attracts everything towards its center because of gravitational force. Earth attracts every particle because of its gravitational force, which is known as its weight. Force of gravitational is always attractive in nature. Earth attracts every single particle towards its center of the force of attraction. So force of attraction is known as weight of the particle. So students, what is actually the center of gravity? Center of gravity is the algebraic sum of moment of particle, where is zero. So anti-clockwise weight of all particle is equal to clockwise weight of the particle. So W1, so let us take one example which is given in your books. This object is contained of the different particle. All the particles W1, W2, W3, W4, W5, W6 are, all particles are falling downwards in a parallel manners. Okay, so G, where is G? Actually, whole particles is consist of whole particle is acted toward its Z, which is center. So if we can say what is total weight of this body, total weight of body is equal to W1 plus W2 plus W3 and so on. So weight is considered to act at the point G, this G, so such that the algebraic sum of the moment due to weight W1 and W2 of each particle about the point G is zero. So we can explain the definition of center of gravity. So it is the point about which the algebraic sum of moment of weight of all the body, of the all the particles constituting the body is zero. This zero is very important over here. If we cannot write zero, because where the whole body weight becomes zero, you all are having a, some of you having a talent that we can rotate the book on the finger, and we can rotate the book from the center only, from the center, not from the sidewise. So where the whole of the algebraic point is zero. So this question note is very important. They can ask, so write the factor on which the center of gravity of a body depends. So it depends upon the mass on the or the shape, distribution of mass. So can they can ask the question also, Rajay. So can the center of gravity change when the body is deformed? Can it is changed? Yes. So it can be changed. So center of body of a uniform wire is in the middle of its length, but if the same wire is bent in the form of circle, then its center of gravity will then be in the center of the circle. It is not necessary that the center of gravity is always within the material of the body. We can take a example of a ring. So this topic is very important. So we can take the examples from these objects, and these are the position of the gravity. So same way we can find out the center of gravity of a lamina. So irregular lamina is there which has a irregular shape. So from this irregular shape, where the diagonals are given, different sides are given, from there we can put a holes, and from that hole we can hang the body one by one, and where this whole body consisted, that point is diagonal meet, that is the center of the gravity. So like this we can read this topic and try to find out the exercise 1B. Thank you.